Hey guys, welcome back to Kerbal Space Program. We're getting some maneuvering done here with the asteroid recovery vessel today. Just trying to line up the final bit of the rendezvous. As you can see here, I'm just kind of pointing in different directions and trying to get things lined up correctly, get my best closest approach possible. Just kind of hit the RCS in various directions. Right now we have like 150 kilometers, so I'm going to work on closing that in to like, you know, within physics range. 2.5 kilometers is kind of the goal. And this is how I usually do these kind of rendezvous at slow speeds like this. I just bring up the target info and burn the RCS in various directions. It takes very little to actually correct at these kind of distances and stuff. So just keep doing that until we get closed in. And as you can see, I ended up getting a pretty good approach, 114 meters, so plenty close enough to get this done. We're gonna just have MechJeb actually do the warp forward and the burn to slow down. It'll probably be a little bit inaccurate, but it lets me do the time warp without having to worry too much about overshooting my my target and all that stuff. So we're within physics range of an asteroid for the first time. I've never actually, at this point, I hadn't actually seen one in person, so I was kind of excited about that. It's one of the little itty bitty ones, but that's actually good because I didn't really have a ship big enough to deal with a bigger one. It's kind of weird that this was just in orbit of Kerbin already, but I don't know if that's supposed to be that way or not. We have a maneuver that came up and whatever. Don't need to worry about that. Got important stuff going on here. So now that we're within range, the idea is I'm just going to have this go point towards the target, and I'm going to close the distance. I'm trying to do the center of mass as best as possible. It's from what I've learned about this, it's fairly important to actually get that accurate because you don't want to burn around in circles. It's like you wouldn't want an unbalanced spaceship. This is basically just going to turn into a spaceship. So we got the claw deployed, ready to go. Once we get this into a stabilized orbit, of course, we're going to want to send up Kerbals to actually come and do science and learn things, I'm sure. But for now, it's time to just slowly close the gap. I believe I have to hit at a decent speed in order for this to actually, the claw to actually work. So, we probably want to be going like, you know, at least a meter per second, I would think. It's not like docking, there's no magnet or anything involved in this, it's really just a claw that attaches. It's not very realistic, I guess, but you know, it kind of makes sense. And I think these claws will probably be useful for other stuff. I'm curious if they attach on places like Kerbin or, more importantly, Gilly, because I have a lot of trouble landing on Gilly, and this would probably make that a lot easier. But I'm not sure if they work there or not, so we'll have to figure that out, I suppose, at some point in the future. I could just look it up, I suppose, too. I probably will, in fact, because I don't want to send something all the way to Gilly and have it not work, so. And, so, it's pretty much exactly the same as docking. The nice thing is that you don't really need to worry about facing a certain way. There's, you know, you just hit it anywhere, pretty much. Trying to get as close to the center as I can, like I said, because I don't want to spin the ship out. There is a pivot point on this claw that lets me kind of center it up better with the center of mass and the center of thrust, so we'll make some fine-tuning adjustments on that. But this isn't too much bigger than the spacecraft, actually. I think it's a Class E, or I don't remember how the classifications work, but it's the smallest of the asteroids that are in the game. And the moment of truth, I neglected to put lights on this. I really should have, but I didn't really think about it. Fortunately, the sun's out where we are, but it's still pretty dark. If this had been like in the actual dark, it would have been outright impossible, probably. And the RCS is just flipping out because the smart ASS is like, oh god, I don't know what to do anymore, but we got it worked out. I cheated there using the time warp, but you know, the game was, the MechJeb specifically, not really the game, but MechJeb was doing something kind of silly, so kind of have to do that. Just like how when the space stations start flopping too bad, sometimes you have to do that. So yeah, there she sits. We're gonna work on doing some corrections to this orbit. As it stands right now, This thing's in a pretty elliptical orbit, and I want to get it into a more circular orbit so it's easier to rendezvous with, and also change its inclination to be, relative to the equator. Pretty much is my idea. I want it to be in an equatorial orbit because there's going to be a space station I'll probably send up. In real life, I guess the International Space Station isn't, you know, it's not in an equatorial orbit because they want to be able to launch from Russia to get there easily too. So it's at like a slightly inclined orbit of like 20 degrees or 40 degrees. I don't remember what it is. But it basically passes over, you know, a lot more of the surface of the Earth that way. And lets them, you know, gives them more opportunities to launch. But I don't have those concerns. We only ever launch from Kerbal Space Center, so it's not a problem. And what I'm doing right now is we're just looking at our orbit right now. Like you can see, it's kind of a silly orbit, you know. And I'm just gonna let MechJeb actually figure out what sort of burn we need to do. We still have a pretty decent amount of delta V available, considering the mass is probably fairly high. I would imagine that rock weighs a fair amount. I kind of wish there was a way to know exactly what the mass was, but it seems like you just kind of get a general idea. So this ship's not having any trouble turning it around or anything though, so it's lucky our first one was one of these little ones. If we'd run into one of the big ones, like I said, I just don't have the thrust to deal with that. You probably need to send up more than one ship to some of those too, like more than one engine cluster to try to balance it out, because I would imagine that would be hard to get everything centered up well enough. But so we're going to use up most of our delta V that we have available, just changing our inclination here. And it shouldn't take too much to put this into a better orbit, circularize the orbit a little bit. I'm probably going to put it in a higher orbit too, because this is actually kind of going to be the core. The way I have this designed is it's going to be the core of a research base. You can see that there's a docking port there. Basically, the claw is just going to end up being permanently attached with a docking port available so we can add components to the space station later. Now, we're really high out here. What we're doing at this point is just, why is the periaps going down? I don't know what we're doing exactly. But I'm just, you know, fine-tuning the orbit more. Basically, I think we might have had the reverse direction or something. I'm not sure. I definitely have a really low periaps. Like I said, this is all post-commentary. I recorded so much Kerbal Space Program in a few weeks, This was probably recorded, I don't know, at least two or three months ago, so some of this is a little hard for me to remember. I do review the video before I do commentary a little bit, but I don't remember exactly what we were doing here. But I realized that my center of mass was off, and this thing it's actually fairly funky trying to get this thing centered. I don't like the way this works. I don't really know if there's a better way, but it's kind of touchy trying to get it centered up good. Just because it seems like a tiny movement moves the spacecraft a ridiculous amount. So I don't like that very much. But we're still on a collision course here for Kerbin. And like I said, this asteroid was on a crazy elliptical orbit. So I'm going to bring it down to something approaching a reasonable orbit. I think we're still changing the... Yeah, we're still at a 47 degree inclination. That is what I was doing, is changing the inclination. Trying to get it down to zero. And get this thing. See what I mean? Like, the thing just wobbles so much. And I'm, especially with this asteroid, it's probably fairly sensitive to being off just because it's so smaller. But I think we got it. I kind of wish that they'd add articulation like that to more parts in this game. I know there's Infernal Robotics, but it'd be kind of nice if the stuff was just built into the game. I definitely like having the articulation on that claw. There's other things I could think of that would be useful. But there we go, our inclination's pretty rapidly changing there, so we'll get this thing sorted out. So at this point we're just stabilizing the orbit a little bit, bringing it down into a much lower orbit. This isn't the final orbit that it's going to end up in. We end up boosting it up into a higher orbit where, like I said, I'm going to put a research base on it and that sort of stuff. basically the idea of the research base is that it's gonna study the asteroid, you know, pretty much is what I'm thinking. I don't really know what else I'm gonna do. I kind of feel like every space station needs to have like a general purpose, and I'm not real sure exactly what I'll figure out for that, but asteroids are just kind of begging for a space station. I wish this one was bigger, because I'd actually like to build stuff on the surface, but we're not ready to be capturing the big boys yet. Not by a long shot. There is a big one that's actually coming on an intercept course. It's actually going to collide with Kerbin in a couple months, so we'll probably try to get that one. I've been tracking it in the tracking station. I think it's like it's whatever the biggest one is. I think it's either E or A. I get those mixed up, but it's the biggest one. So I'm going to try to get something where we can intercept it far enough out that we can hopefully make enough of a course correction to arrow break it a little bit, maybe, and capture it. It'd probably be a really dangerous thing to do in real life, is try to arrow break an asteroid, but we'll do what we can. I don't know how much thrust I'm going to need, because I really just don't know how much the thing weighs. I know it weighs a lot and all that, but we'll have to figure that out as we go, I guess. I could look up on the forums how much they weigh. I'm sure it's fairly standardized, but I don't really know. So, anyway, we're just finishing this burn up. At this point, the asteroid's in a nice orbit, much nicer orbit than it was, and we can get somebody up here to actually come check it out, which I'm pretty excited about. Before we do that, though, we have a couple of housekeeping things to deal with here. And like I said, I really wish I'd put lights on this, because it's kind of hard to tell what I'm doing. But you can see here, there's a main section with this claw. There's a little like intermediate section with a probe core and stuff, and then there's this rear section that is just meant to detach and get out of the way so that we can actually hook up a space station to this. I guess there's a probe body there. It has its own power and all that stuff. So go ahead and detach the drive section here and just leave that as the beginning of a base. Slowly, carefully back away here. Probably wouldn't want to do that in real life either, firing those RCS thrusters quite so aggressively right near the station, but you know, it works out. And we'll just go ahead and crash this thing back into Kerbin and get ready for our next adventure. Get some guys up here to take a look at this thing. Alright, so we're back down at the Space Center. We have a crew ready to visit an asteroid for the first time. So this will be a momentous day. I think you can get science from every class of asteroid. It's not a tremendous amount. There's probably more science if you get it in orbit of the Mun or Minmus or whatever, but I don't feel like dealing with that. The multiplier would probably apply. I'm not really sure if there are asteroids that are close to, say, like Duna or anything like that, that you could capture way out there. I don't know how that works, actually. That's something I'm kind of curious about. This is just kind of a modified version of our standard crew launcher. It probably has a lot more fuel than it actually needs for this mission. It definitely does, actually. But I was feeling lazy and I didn't feel like building a ship specifically for this. So we're just going to be lazy. And it's bringing up a part, too, while we're at it. You know, it's got a little docking hub and stuff, so it's good to have the extra fuel, but like I said, it's probably more than we needed. The docking adapter's not that big. But it has an antenna, because I neglected to put an antenna on the previous section that's already up there. And it's got docking adapters, so we can attach some modules and whatnot to the station as we go here. So it's just pretty much a beefed up version of my standard crew launcher. It's got a much bigger drive section and stuff. Like, I guess it's kind of more related to my moon shuttle thing, my moon launcher. But we'll just go ahead and get the rendezvous taken care of here, and I'll meet you out there. Alright, so our brave crew is quickly approaching the asteroid, and should be, you know, it's kind of in visual range, I guess. I believe I still neglected to put lights on anything. I do forget all the time for some reason to put lights on stuff. But basically we did the same thing we did previously, where we just, this is just a standard rendezvous now, actually. It's not a big deal at all. So we're just kind of sliding in, getting ready to do the docking. The pretty standard fare. This is just like anything else at this point. Well, that's a pretty view there. You get the sun in the background. Fortunately, we're coming in on the day side again. I didn't really plan it. I don't ever really plan these things. Just kind of do it. But got a nice view of Kerbin down there as well. I guess we're flying right over the Space Center, it looks like right now, which is always kind of fun. So I have this set to do whole force roll thing, so everything will be lined up nice. The asteroid is just kind of arbitrary how we dock to that. So it's all just going to be based on the docking clamp thing that we attached. And MechJeb is actually doing a decent job of docking for once. Kind of slid a little past it, but for whatever reason, I've been having a lot of MechJeb docking issues, so it's kind of nice to have it actually perform correctly, because I can just kind of lay back and not worry about it too much, which I prefer. Docking gets kind of dull at a certain point. And contact. Yay! Oh, we bounced off, but there we go. So, we delivered another component for a future space station here, and more importantly, we got our first actual eyes-on view of an asteroid with a manned vessel here, so we'll be able to, I'm sure, learn lots about the formation of the Kerbal system and all that stuff we can imagine. So, what I wanted to do here was just kind of turn this thing around so that we're kind of more in the sunlight, make it a little bit easier to see what we were doing. And it's kind of turning ridiculously. I guess there's a couple probe bodies and stuff on this thing now, so it has a decent amount of torque. But I don't think I made that easier at all. But probably somewhat. It's not exactly going to be easy, I guess, no matter how I have it angled. But kind of wish there was a way to like permanently lock a docking port, so you had to manually override it. And like, I don't know. I guess there is sort of, but. Doing force roll here, trying to... What am I trying to do? Oh, I was trying to get the antenna pointing down. That's what I was doing. Because the antenna is supposed to go down. Alright, so now that we got that stabilized, I believe it's going to be time for an EVA here in a second. If we can actually see the hatch. Where's he going to come out? I quick save whenever I do stuff like this now, because I've had enough stuff explode and generally just not work right that I prefer to just do it that way. So you see like this asteroid really isn't that big. You see him compared to a Kerbal here. It's not big at all. It's just a big boulder pretty much. But we can go get a sample probably. I think there's really not much you can do science wise right now. Pretty much just collect the surface sample, and that, I think that's it. But, anyway, I was really excited to get this done. Asteroids are really cool. I'm glad that they're in the game. It's gonna, probably improve some stuff. I don't know how many asteroids I'll really deal with in the end, but it'll probably give me something a little bit more challenging to do, try to capture one of those big ones at some point. So, that's gonna take care of things for this episode. I do want to thank you all for watching. And if you like the video, please leave a like, and I appreciate the support. I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.